It's all about house and home. Yeah, yeah. We care about improving lifestyles. It's all about the betterment for your life with house and home. Yeah, it's all about the betterment. Coming up tonight on Haus Home, Nicole shares the taste of PNG kitchen with James from Omni Limited as they bake Anzac cookies in memory of the Anzac Day. Shopping with Brand Bell features an excellent product range of the famous Hitachi brand. Pali from the Port Moresby Nature Park shares a few tips on compost piles and soil improvement for gardeners. Followed by Tina Pomat and John Gavuli featuring BSB stem deposits for the month of April. This week on Healthy Minds, Dr Ambi speaks on the topic of cancer and mental illness, and Godreeeman wraps up the show with tech people featuring the FIFA tournament. Good night through all viewers, me at me one bill through long you plus tap one the me plus long house and home. I'm definitely sure all students had a great time relaxing and enjoying their holidays. Well, you take care and don't let the holiday fever get the better of you. Be good, okay? Now, the ongoing downpour is really doing a great job helping our people along the highways, nourishing the soil, and I know the gardeners are looking forward to harvesting in due time. I remember back when I was in the East New Britain province of Papua New Guinea, we had a huge garden and it was so much fun learning how to plant tomatoes, peanuts, corn, and other vegetables. Great experience. Now the show must go on. I'm sure you've had a look at the lineup for this episode. Haus Home is pleased to have James from Omni Limited to share his recipe on how to bake Anzac cookies in memory of the Anzac Day. Now, without further ado, here now is Easy Meals with Nicole and James. Enjoy.
What do you think you're doing in my kitchen? You got 1 second to get out of here. Feignant, va faire du travail, rester ici à rien faire, alors, va-t'en!
Hi everyone and welcome to Easy Meals. Tonight I am here at the Taste of PNG kitchen and I'm joined by James. How are you doing?
Good, thanks Nicole.
Awesome. Now James is the general manager for Omni Limited, and James, could you tell us a bit about Omni?
Well, we take a lot of pride in our kitchen division here at Omni Limited because we manufacture the highest quality kitchens in Papua New Guinea using only world-class materials at a great price.
And this is just one of the kitchens that you built for Taste of PNG?
Absolutely.
This is awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. So is this where Chef Francois comes and does
yep.
his stuff and all
this
that?
This is his space. It's where he works his magic.
All right. Now, I see that this is an island. Could you tell me a bit about this, because this looks perfect. Where do you get this?
Well, this is a synthetic stone product that we source out of Italy.
Oh, wow.
And the beautiful thing about this particular product here is that it's cheaper than stone, and you can actually repair it easily when it gets scratched or damaged.
How do you do that?
Well, you actually sand and buff it out.
Okay.
It's,
yeah,
sorry, it's pretty simple.
All right, I'm saying simple, but maybe tough.
Yeah.
I have to call the experts or
that's
me
it.
To come do it. Now, for tonight, we're doing Anzac cookies, and James loves doing that. So could you take us through the cooking and show us what to do for it?
Absolutely, let's jump into it.
All right, cool. What do we have here?
Okay, so we've got 85 grams of desiccated coconut. We have 100 grams of butter,
right,
we're gonna melt in a second. We've got 100 grams of oats.
All right, so it can be any other type of oatmeal or what type?
It's just a simple dried oatmeal is best
okay.
to this.
All right.
We have 100 grams of sugar and 100 grams of flour.
Flour.
Super simple.
Plain flour?
Just plain flour.
Plain flour.
Okay.
What's this?
As well, we've got 1 tablespoon of baking soda.
Baking soda.
And we're going to have it use a tablespoon of golden syrup.
Golden syrup. All right. Now, with the Anzac cookies, mm-hmm. there's a history to it, right?
Oh, a huge amount of history to it.
Okay.
It's an Australian icon, but it's something that we eat all year round, but it's really special around this time of the year with the Anzac Day.
So, in memory of the Anzac Day, you're going to show me how to do the Anzac cookies?
Absolutely.
All right. Could you carry on?
Okay. So, what we're going to do, we're going to mix a desiccated coconut.
All right. What can I do?
We'll get to that in a second.
Okay. I'll just wait.
Desiccated coconut.
Yes.
The oats. And the flour.
So, all the dry ingredients.
All the dry ingredients, we're going to get mixed in first.
Okay.
Okay. Get this in the bowl. What you can do for me, if you want to mix that up with
the wooden spoon
there.
Fine. And when does the sugar, is that a sugar?
Yep, sugar we're going to handle into the pan in a second. So before we do anything else, I'm going to chuck on the oven at 180.
Okay, that's good. Okay, and I'll just put this away. So I have to keep mixing this?
Yeah, just make sure it's all thoroughly mixed through.
All right. Is that all good?
That's all good.
Okay.
And this next bit is really, really easy. We're going to put the stove on a low heat.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll let you do that because I'm not really sure how to handle that. Low heat.
Nice and low. Yep. Okay.
And what do we add? We just wait for it.
We're going to wait for a heat up.
All right.
We don't want to have it too hot because now we're going to add in the butter.
Okay.
Let that melt. Then we're going to add the bicarb.
Yes.
And then we'll add the sugar.
Sugar. How much is the butter again?
The butter is 100 grams.
100 grams of butter.
Yeah.
All right. Now, while waiting for this to heat up, you made a mention about Anzac Day.
Mm.
Do you have a history attached to it?
Yeah, well, Anzac Day itself has its roots back into the First World War because the day itself marks the first military engagement by Australian and New Zealand forces in that war. Now, it doesn't just mark World War I. The event actually captures any involvement of Australian troops and commemorates the people that fought and died for our nations.
For the nation. So it carries on to World War II.
Absolutely, and I've got a lot of family history attached to that. My grandfather fought here in Papua New Guinea in the Second World War.
Do you know which area he was in?
Well, he did fight over in Lae, but he spent most of his time in Bougainville. I think we're about hot enough now.
All right. What do we do next?
Okay, what we're going to do, we're going to put the butter in. Yep, that's it. Now we're not going to burn this, we just want to melt this butter in here. Now we did this at room temperature, so it's not going to take very long. And then we're going to mix in all the other ingredients as soon as it's melted.
Okay.
As soon as everything's melted, it's going to let it mix with the other dry ingredients we're going to put in here.
Yeah. Also, we all get to put it in there.
Exactly. Then we're going to mix that through.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take the kettle that's just boiled.
Oh, you already boiled that?
Yep.
Okay.
And I'm going to place in 2 teaspoons of boiling water in with a bicarbonate soda.
All right. 2 teaspoons. Viewers, remember that? 2 teaspoons with the bicarbonate soda.
Okay.
Do I mix
it? Yeah, I'll mix that. I'll just turn off this gas. Done. Okay. Well, the next step, we're going to measure out 1 teaspoon of golden syrup and add that to the butter.
Okay.
Okay.
So can you do that now?
Absolutely.
Do I have to do anything? I'll just wait here.
Oh, you'll wait here. Your turn's coming up.
Okay.
Yep. What we're going to do now is we're going to mix this in. Mix the golden syrup right through the butter.
Yes.
Just want to make sure that's all mixed through.
Looks about mixed.
Nice consistency there.
Okay.
And what we're going to do now, now's the fun part.
Okay.
Yep. Now, the last thing we do with this mixture is we're going to add sugar into it.
Okay.
We're going to add
How much sugar is that again?
100 grams.
100 grams of sugar. It can be any sugar or white sugar?
Preferably caster sugar.
Caster sugar, okay.
Just need to get this all mixed through. So next, we're going to pour our mixture of butter, sugar, bicarb soda, and golden syrup into the dry ingredients. Okay, so we're going to pour this in here. Get every little last...
We're going to pour everything in.
Yeah, we're going to pour every last little bit out. All right. Now, what you have to do here now is mix this through so it's an even consistency.
Do I do that with my hand? Or
you can do it with this, with the wooden spoon.
All right, so just mix it up. Let me know if I'm doing the right thing.
No, it's fine. It's super easy.
Okay.
This is a great recipe you can do with your kids because it's so easy to follow.
Okay, but under adult supervision?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
Oh, look, you're doing fine. Almost there, so we just need to make sure we get all of the... We get all the dried ingredients moved through, so we don't want to see any kind of free-flowing coconut on there. Everything's mixed now. What we're going to do, we're going to put little round lumps of the mixture onto the baking tray.
Are we going to use our hands?
Yeah, we may as well use our hands. Make it a bit fun.
I'll let you go ahead.
So we're going to go get one first.
All right, can I?
Yep, absolutely.
Did it have to be like a regular shape of this?
Oh, it'll smooth out in the oven.
So
we want it about the size of a dessert spoon. But it'll smooth out a fair bit, so we want to give it a bit more distance on the tray.
Okay.
That's perfect size.
All right. So do you want me to just roll them up, give them to you,
yes,
and you space them?
So we've got...
Like that?
Yep, absolutely. So the good thing is, because this cooks really, really quickly,
how long does it?
Between 8 and 10 minutes at 180 degrees.
Okay.
So it means that if we make a mistake,
yes,
and we have to redo a batch, yeah, we make them too big or too small, you're only waiting 10 minutes to find out. So let's just get maybe one more small one on here.
That bit?
Yep, perfect.
All right.
And we'll stick it in the oven.
This
yep.
for you? It's already at 180 degrees,
yep,
right?
180 degrees.
Do you set the timer for it?
Yep, so between 8 and 10 minutes, and we'll just watch through the door to see when it's done.
All right.
Okay?
All good? 8 to 10 minutes.
8 to 10 minutes.
All right. So viewers, 8 to 10 minutes, and don't worry, we'll do a second batch for this.
Oh, we'll do a few more batches.
Let's go. Looking forward to see the end product.
Okay.
Alright.
But look, sorry, it's about time to get these biscuits out of the oven.
Alright, viewers, and the cookies upcoming. Do you need help with them? No.
No, it's
fine.
Here.
Oh, look,
oh,
at,
look at them. They look great.
I just put a plate here. Oh, wow.
Wow, look at them. Perfect size.
So is this what the color needs to look like when you bring it up?
They could probably be a little bit less brown on the edges, but
okay,
still these are perfect and they'll still be nice and soft and chewy on the inside.
Okay, so how would you know if they're cooked, like when you press it and
yeah, so
it
the best Anzac cookies are still soft. So what's really important with these is that some batches will cook faster or slower than others, depending on how thick they are.
Okay.
So our first batch cooked a lot faster.
Yes.
Then our second.
Second, okay. All right. You don't mind if I try?
No, go nuts.
It's cold. Mmm.
What do you think?
It's really good. Not bad.
Yeah, thanks.
Before I speak. Well, viewers, there you have it. Thanks, James, for showing us one of your simple recipes.
No, you're more than welcome.
And I have a mouthful of food in me. Anyway, viewers, join us next time on Easy Meals. Hope you enjoy this recipe at home.
Great job, guys. That was Easy Meals with Nicole and James, the general manager for Omni Limited, and they got to bake Anzac cookies in memory of the Anzac Day. Viewers, Omni Limited is specialized in providing the highest quality kitchens in Papua New Guinea, and if you'd like to know more about how they operate, feel free to get in touch with the House and Home team on the email address, which is houseandhome@emtv.com.pg. We take our first break, and when we come back, we join Leon on Shopping with Brian Bell, featuring an excellent product range of the famous Hitachi brand. Stay with us. Welcome back. Now, Brian Bell is known for its after-sales services, great products, and great prices with genuine accessories that go along with them. In this edition of Shopping with Brian Bell, we check out an outstanding product range of the famous Hitachi brand, all available at the Brian Bell Trade Electrical. Products that can definitely cater for both the domestic and industrial tasks. Have a look.
Hey, hey, Mr. B.
Hi there, and welcome to another Shopping with Brian Bell. I'm your host, Leon Gowie. In this segment, we're at Brian Bell Trade Electrical, and we'll take a look at some of the Hitachi products we have available here. Products that are perfect for both domestic and industrial use. So, let's not delay anymore. Let's get straight into it. Hitachi is a multinational conglomerate that was started in Japan and still is located in Japan. Hitachi is a diverse company with a range of different products in several industries, including information and technology and digital media, electronic systems, automotive systems, building and construction, and construction machinery. Hitachi was founded in 1901 by Namihai Odaira, an electrical engineer who then moved his company to Tokyo in 1918. The company name, Hitachi, was derived by superimposing two kanji symbols, Hai, meaning the sun, and Tachi, meaning rise. A great name for a great brand that you can find here at Brian Bell Trade Electrical. Now, the first lot of products that I want to display from Hitachi are the sets we have available here. This three-piece set with a cordless driver, a torch, and this reciprocating handsaw is absolutely perfect. The more the merrier, right? And this is exactly what this set is. You don't just get one, not two, but three quality Hitachi products that you can use. A great range of tools either for the home or for tradies. Now, the next set is this two-in-one drill and torch set. This is perfect for Mr. Fix-It in the house or the DIY warrior, or even you tradies out there that need a drill bit and a torch for all your tasks. This gives great portability and also allows you ample light for drilling around dark areas. Now, I must also mention Brian Bell's after-sales service guarantee. This is a Brian Bell outlet, of course, and here at Brian Bell, we provide this for our Hitachi products. That means should anything ever go wrong, which is highly unlikely with these Hitachi products, we stock and sell genuine parts in our service center that can cater to fix those damaged merchandise. Also here at Brian Bell Trade Electrical, we have genuine Hitachi accessories. These include your drill bits, discs for your grinders, and other small Hitachi tools and accessories for the Hitachi products that we stock and sell. Now, the next lot of products that we'll see from Hitachi are slightly bigger than the previous products that we saw. These products are perfect for the construction and building sites. These are your drop saws and disc grinders. Now, if you're not too technical savvy with these products, or if you don't understand what they are, here's a quick lesson for you. A drop saw is also referred to as a mitre saw and is a power tool used to make quick and accurate cross cuts on wood. This can be adjusted to different angles for cutting. A disc grinder, also known as an angle grinder, is as the name suggests. This is a handheld power tool for abrasive cutting and polishing. These Hitachi drop saws and disc grinders are absolutely perfect to have in your house, whether you're a DIY person or a tradie. They can do all your jobs for you without any hassle, and they're quality products. Now, another quality product from Hitachi that's new here in Brian Bell Trade Electrical are our grass trimmers. We've been experiencing a lot of rain recently, and you don't want those unwanted bushes, shrubs, or grass growing in your backyard. Get one of these trimmers and get rid of all those bushes around your house. Keep your yards tidy and avoid nasty surprises in high grass. Keep your lawn short and neat so your children and other family members can enjoy the outdoors. Now, the last lot of products that I want to bring to your attention that you can find here at Brian Bell from Hitachi are these bigger power tools. They include the Hitachi Saw Table Stationery, the Hitachi Bench Planer, and the Hitachi Stand Saw. The Hitachi Saw Table Stationery. Now, the name of this product is pretty self-explanatory. What it does is it gets larger pieces of timber or plywood and it cuts it into smaller sizes to fit whatever job you want to do. For example, cutting plywood to make a cabinet or a 4x4 to make a frame for your house. This product is perfect for doing that. The Hitachi Bench Planer. This Hitachi Bench Planer is ideal to level or smoothen out unleveled and rough surfaces. This can cater to a wide range of different timbers. The Hitachi Stand Saw. Now, this last product is self-explanatory. It's pretty much a drop saw that's fixed onto a work surface. This gives you a sturdy work surface to work on. Well, there you have it, folks. You've seen in this segment that Hitachi is a quality brand that's available here at Brian Bell Trade Electrical. Come on in and check out the range, whether it's domestic or industrial. These tools can do the job for you. And also, I must remind you about our Mother's Choice competition. It's up and running at our home centers. Simply shop and you just might win something for mom, like these people down here who have won something in our weekly draw. Congratulations to you all. Thank you for shopping with Brian Bell. And always remember, quality products, great service and great value. That's Brian Bell. Until next time, goodbye and God bless.
Hey, hey, Mr. B. Right on, Mr. B.
That was Shopping with Brian Bell, featuring the famous Hitachi brand, having some great handyman products for you to check out at the Brian Bell Trade Electrical, formerly known as ESCO, located at the Gardens Industrial Area. Coming up after the break, we join Pali from the Port Moresby Nature Park for some tips on soil improvement and how you can create your own compost pile. See you soon. Welcome back. Research has confirmed that fruits and vegetables are the main sources of nutrients and immunity for mankind. On this edition on gardening, Pali from the Port Moresby Nature Park shares with us tips on soil improvement, compost pile, and how you can make your own garden. Well, if you're thinking of starting a small garden at home, I'm sure Pali has tips to help you out. Your garden needs your love and affection, and yes, your utmost attention. If you have more time for your garden, you will have more food for your family, and it'll help you in the long run. But first, you have to know what type of soil is suitable for a new garden. Hi and welcome to Gardening with House and Home. I'm here at the Port Moresby Nature Park, and I love this place because it's so peaceful. Anyway, for this edition, we'll be focusing on the importance of fruits and vegetables together with soil improvement and compost. Now, lately, I have been chatting with a couple of people who have small gardens in their backyard, and I've given a few simple ideas on how they get to make and maintain their small gardens. Very interesting. Now, from the islands to the highlands and down to the coastal areas of Papua New Guinea, certain people have their own ways on how they get to make and nurture the soil of their gardens. It's good to get views from certain people who have a fair knowledge about gardening, soil improvement, cultivation, and so forth. We'll now hear from Pali, and she will also share with us tips on how you can create compost for your gardens.
Hi, my name is Pali Palisha, and I'm one of the horticulturists here at Port Moresby Nature Park. What I basically do here at Port Moresby Nature Park is, currently I'm stationed down at the nursery. So what I do is I basically propagate plants from cuttings and seeds. I maintain the growth and health of plants. I apply chemical if they are affected by disease or pests. Identify plants, names of plants, and their characteristics, basic characteristics we need to know about a plant, if it's toxic, it's poisonous, or if it has herbal properties. So that's basically what I do down at the nursery. From time to time, I come around, walk around in the park to see the plants, observe them if they are in their they're well conditioned. If they're affected by pest and disease, we would also treat the plants out in the park. I also do other things such as educating the students that come in the park during education program. We have the education program in the park. So we educate the students about the wildlife and also the plants that we have and their importance in the ecosystem. And currently I'm also training urban youths. Urban youths are here in Port Moresby Nature Park. We have around 10 of them here at the park, and I'm doing a horticulture training with the urban youths in the park as well. I would like to share you the importance of vegetables and garden food. Okay, first of all, vegetables and garden food are fresh, straight from the gardens, and they contain a lot of vitamins and nutrients which our body needs for our day-to-day living and survival. So we need those nutrients and vitamins to fight diseases and sicknesses that we have, and it's good for our health and well-being. So those are the main things that we need in order to survive from our day-to-day activities, which is vitamins and nutrients from the vegetables and fresh garden foods. I would like to share with you how we cultivate the land back then in my village. I come from Southern Islands Province, Arave District, and my small village would be Batri, okay, it's called Batri. And I haven't been to my village or my home province since I was born, okay. I grew up in Port Moresby and raised in Port Moresby. So I don't know how they cultivate land back then. But I ask my parents how they cultivate land or how my village looks like. So I will share with you how we cultivate the land back in our village. What they do is they have, if they want to do a garden, they go 3 to 5 kilometers away from where they live, the house, and they don't plant any or make any gardens at the backyard where they live, but they go 3 to 5 kilometers away in the forest or if it's savanna grassland. And what they basically do is they go in the forest, they cut down the trees, the bushes, any vegetation of any sort, and they let them dry. They let the vegetation dry maybe for a month, and then later they come back and they bend the bush down, or bend all this vegetation down where the, on the land that they're gonna plant foods, because they believe that if they bend all the vegetation where they're gonna do garden on the soil, it's gonna give back nutrients to their soil. So they don't apply any chemicals of any sort. They use natural process or natural materials, which are plants, okay? So they bend it down on that land, and after they bend it down, they let the ash of the plants stay there for a month. And then after a month, they go back and they spread the ash on the land and they dig the land up. They don't do any drainage system or whatever. They just dig the soil up with a stick or a stake. They dig the soil up and they plant their foods. And near their home, they have a small backyard garden, which they plant only taros and bananas, and it's called the emergency garden. For events, or events such as if there's a funeral, someone died, they wouldn't go to the garden, which is 3 to 5 kilometers away from their home. So for 1 week, if they stayed at the house, they would depend on that emergency garden, which is at their backyard, which is they feed on taros and bananas. That's back then in my village where my people cultivate land to plant food crops. Now we're gonna move on to composting. Okay, so before I go into composting, I'll define to you what a compost is. A compost is basically made up of plant materials, so organic materials. Organic materials includes plants, any plant material, leaves, stems, branches of trees, dead branches of trees you put together, those are all organic materials. So when you put them together and make a pile, it's a compost pile. That's what a compost is, and I will share with you some tips on how to make your own compost, a compost recipe. Firstly, find a sunny spot, but not directly to the sun. The compost needs heat. Second, make square or rectangle boundary with timber, aluminium or cement. It's fine. The foundation can be soil or cement. If you have enough finance to build a proper compost shed, then please do so. Third, collect biodegradable or organic things such as food peelings, food scraps, leftover foods, papers, boxes, leaves, sticks, etc. Four, break big things apart and make it small and pile them together in the square fence boundary that you made in the beginning. As you make the pile evenly, stop when the pile is 50 or 60 centimeters thick and apply some nice black topsoil evenly on the surface of the pile. Continue with the pile and soil until you reach the surface and stop. 5. Before you close it with a canvas or plastic, get a rubber hose and water the pile down for 30 minutes or less until you can see the water reaching the base of the pile and stop. 6. Now put the canvas over and close the pile tightly by putting rocks or branches on the canvas. Let the pile boil down for 2 to 3 months, then turn the pile around every week or fortnightly so that all the plant material decomposes down. And the last tip, number 7, is you have to monitor the compost pile every now and then. And these are 7 steps on how to make your own compost pile. I'm Pali from Port Moresby Nature Park. See you next time.
And that's all we have for you on this edition. I hope you've enjoyed watching and have picked out a thing or two. Now be sure to join us next time as we go in detail how to plant certain vegetables step by step. See you next time.
Oh.
That was Gardening with Haus Home featuring Pali from the Port Moresby Nature Park with tips on soil improvement, how you can create your compost pile, and how you can start up a new garden at home. We'll take a quick breather and catch up on the other side with Tina Pomat and John Gavuli featuring BSP stem deposits for the month of April. Stay tuned. You're watching Haus Home, pleased to have your company. For BSP's April's edition, we feature the term deposit account with Tina Pomat and John Gavuli. This is an ideal product for further investment and a larger profit for a long-term goal.
Good evening, viewers, and welcome to another BSP segment. For this month, we feature the term deposit account. If you have 5,000 kina or more and would like to build your savings or achieve long-term goals, a BSP term deposit is ideal for you. The term deposit is an investment account for customers who want to gain a higher rate of interest. This product is available to both individuals and business customers. For investment over 100,000 kina, interest rates are subject to negotiation. There are two categories, deposits less than 100,000 kina and deposits 100,000 kina and over. Interest rates on deposits in excess of 100,000 kina are negotiable between the bank and the customer, whilst interest rates on deposits less than 100,000 kina are not negotiable. The interest is calculated on a fixed rate and is paid at maturity. The account is for anyone who has 5,000 kina or more to invest and can include individuals, clubs and societies, businesses, companies, law firms, and non-government organizations. Some of the standard features include competitive interest rates, terms vary from 1 month to a maximum of 4 years, interest will be paid at maturity where term deposit is 1, 3, or 6 months. For deposit lodged for terms 12 months or longer, interest can be paid at maturity or 6 monthly. On maturity, interest can be reinvested with the principal or paid to a nominated account. Prepayments not permitted, 15% government withholding tax applies on the interest. For more information on rates, please visit our website at www.bsp.com.pg. We will now hear from John Gavuli, a banking education officer, who will elaborate further on the benefits of term deposit.
For term deposit product, we've got five main benefits to it. Number one, we've got a competitive interest rates offered. And number two, earns a secure return on investment. On maturity of a 1 month or 2 month, 6 months or 12 months, interest rates can be reinvested or paid to a nominated account. Number three, deposit is held for a term and helps prepare the customer for bigger and better investments. Okay, number four, it's an avenue to accumulate wealth. You want to realize your savings goals or you want to build your savings, this is the right and ideal product for the customers. Number five, it can be used as security to obtain a loan with BSP. Either you're applying for a personal loan or home loan, this is ideal for you.
Thank you, John. Well, viewers, that brings us to the end of our segment. Until then, pleasant viewing. Goodbye.
That was Tina Pomat and John Gavuli featuring BSP's term deposit account. An ideal account for investment and available for those who'd like to gain a higher rate of interest. This is available to both individuals and businesses. Coming up after the break, Dr. Ambi speaks on the topic of cancer and mental illness, so stay watching. Welcome back. Cancer and mental illness are the components of a killer disease. It is very hard to cope with such conditions when depression is present and unattended to. We will now hear from Dr. Ambi as she points out some of the facts about cancer and mental illness.
This is Healthy Mind with Dr. Ambi, proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
Welcome to Healthy Mind. Empower viewers to stay mentally healthy. Until next time, take care. Talking about cancer and mental illnesses is one of the most passionate ways that we could give some quality of life to our loved ones. Well, World Health Day, we are continuing to talk about depression. Let's talk. And this is a group of people who need our affection, who need our way of giving gupla hamamaslo or loved one to stay healthy and for a long life to overcome the diagnosis of cancer. So, well, viewers, let's talk about depression among the cancer patients. Cancer and mental illness are very common. You must understand in 1 in 4, whether the cancer patients, whether we are adults or teenage or old age or whatever the children, whatever the group of people, whoever we belongs to, we may experience depression at any point of our time when we are diagnosed with cancer. Now, and one important point you must look in Osem, that unfortunately many people with the cancer and their family members actually believe quite normal. They think it is normal to have depression. But or sometimes you feel sad and we don't think that there is an alarm or there is something you must think him. This la me depression. Or feel him sad, suppose you may by therapy na look good lo this last side na pay you by pine him that appropriate management or appropriate help you may by give him this last sadness or something called depression, you rouse him. It must seem like a black days for them and they think that's the end for their whole life. Let me tell you, the moment you give him marasinglo this la kind old loved ones, and by all care up and by give him energy by come up and by fighting all kind of, you know, issues around their diagnosis of cancer, or can live very long, actually contribute much better than many other people in the world. It is critically important to establish some issues like tools, or you me as well same doctors may be finding way low identifying, because when we patient and families should make it a point to talk about it, the doctors about their emotional feeling. Plenty times you me by thinking I'm normal and we don't talk about it. Today I want to emphasize you must talk about your feelings to a pastor or priest or somebody you trustworthy or your loved ones. Open up, and even family members must talk about it, because if you feel depressed, anxious and confused, generally you are not yourself, and your family feel that you're not yourself, then your family should ask any doctors, not necessary to go to psychiatrists. You don't have to be only mad or you have not major mental illness to go to psychiatrist. If you don't feel but about yourself as normal as you should be, you must always ask for help. So specifically, you might think also, we must take it a point to go and ask help earlier the better. According to the researchers, you may find him awesome. A lot of persons with the cancer and depression can get treatment, and also in the mind ends up feeling they find in their mind is a huge help has been given to them to overcome their sadness. Now, the categories of psychological distress for cancer patients are adjustment problem. You know, when you're diagnosed, you have to adjust. You've got a new issue in your life. Number two, depression is another category of issue you can have. Anxiety, delirium. The sick itself, suppose you got a brain tumor, then you have a delirium. That means the brain is getting affected by a tumor on it or something like that. And the substance abuse. Sampla man all by cross no go through now, like drink alcohol or sampla way or other drugs, legal drugs and illegal drugs also can bring as an issue of mental health problem. Distress may also occur from some other problems. So what are they? When the cancer patients are having pain management or difficulties with their families, okay, work-related problems, you know, you have cancer, but these issues also can bring depression, financial issues and worries about their children and their future. So those are some of the distress which can contribute towards the onset of depression when you have cancer. The challenges in diagnosis and treatment is another area. That means we don't want, what happens is the challenges in, you know, thinking, yeah, that one is the perceived stigma about psychiatric care. So when you talk about psychiatric care, mental health, we think of everything is mad or something no good or me plus same. You know, can think him because this la kind of stigma can bagger up him, you low quality of life. Come out, ask, get your help. The difficulty in adding yet another problem to the complex of the emotional diagnosis. So you got cancer is an issue and you don't want to know that you're depressed either. Come on, we all are human beings. Get up and ask help. So that one can stop you from getting help. Number three, patients are sometimes embarrassed or ashamed and they are feeling sad and anxious. So all feel him same lo, talk talk lo, yo, me feel him same, me strong pla man, how na me feel him same? No God, you must care up him na ask him help. Fear of physician seeing the patient as a negative light, okay? Those are some of the factors also can challenge in your management of for depression. And finally, physicians may find it difficult to raise sensitive issues related to mental health. So some blood time doctors too all pass him mouth. Me like talk savvy or same. Sampla doctor all no nap kai hurry up na talk savvy. You get mental health issue. Kiss him marasin. Marasin by changing you, then you by yourself very strong. So these are some of the challenges in diagnosing and treating mental health issue when you have cancer. Let me tell you, wake up and ask for help. The special risk factors for psychiatric problem among cancer patients is the type and the stage of cancer. One M hap na plus tap, one M cancer, one M diagnosis, this la can also some of the special factors which can contribute towards mental health issues. Number two, very young or very old patients, they can be very much into depression. Those who are not married or have very little support, also very prone to get all these mental health issues. Those who have few friends, are not affiliated with community or religious people, also can suffer with mental health issues. Patients with a history of psychiatric problem can suffer mental health issue. And also patients with co-occurring other medical problems also can have mental health issues or emotional issues when you have cancer. Now, symptoms of major depression, well, viewers hearing, change in appetite and problem with falling asleep and staying asleep or like waking up very early morning, depressed mood, feeling of hopeless and worthless, suicidal feeling and decreased energy and decreased the capacity to enjoy things and problem with concentration. And also psychomotor agitation and retardation. You feel him like low, nah, no got energy, nah, cranky, nah, cross, come up, nothing. So if you have these symptoms for more than 2 weeks and you're cancer, please let me tell you that you have to get screening for mental health issues. And number two, there are a number of treatments or options like psychotherapy, talking therapy, and also cognitive behavioral therapy. These are things you don't give medicine, but going to a mental health worker, they can always talk to you, bring you out. And number three, antidepressants can help you, and anti-anxiolytic against anxiety can help you, and group therapy and social support and also supportive and expressive therapies can really fight him this like depression or any emotional problem associated with cancer patients. There is hope, my dear, those who are suffering from cancer. And the God loves you so much. And it's critically very important that to consider emotional aspect of cancer care. And we must tell you, get screening and detect early, and they are the first step to go through. And patients and families should make it a point talking to our doctors and about your emotional feeling. And it is important to assume normal and feeling anxious and depressed and overwhelmed are normal. But if it's beyond 2 weeks, ask help. If you do feel depressed, anxious and confused and generally not like yourself, and you and your family should ask help and get your treatment. And for all these symptoms, and what will I tell you, put Papa God first, get your help, and you can overpower and overcome your cancer diagnosis, and you can still very long life. Simpler time, there can be miracles. Well, I'm sure, viewers, you have heard something, and you will change your quality of life after hearing. And this is World Health Day, and Let's Talk is continuing to empower people to stay healthy, mentally healthy. Until next time, take care. God bless you all. Bye bye now.
Healthy Mind was proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
And that was Healthy Minds with Dr. Ambi, stating some of the facts about cancer and mental illness. Patients who are diagnosed need positive attention to reduce depression. Such diseases require mental health care to be incorporated with the treatment plans. Thanks, Dr. Ambi, for the sentiments. We'll take a quick breather and catch up on the other side on Tech People with Godreeeman featuring the FIFA tournament, so stay tuned. Welcome back, you're watching House and Home if you've just tuned in. We'll now join Godreeeman on Tech People featuring the FIFA tournament, which had taken place on Saturday, the 22nd of April. Enjoy.
Hey, everybody, and welcome to Tech People. So it's no big secret that I'm not good at sports. But you want to know what I'm really not good at? Gaming sports. But apparently, it's pretty big here in Palm City. That's why I'm down here at Toro Gaming, where they're having another FIFA 17 tournament, and where I get to find out just exactly how big FIFA really is.
We belong together, together, like we were something more. And if not, like maybe we could lie.
As a noob to sporting games, tournaments like these are a great way to find out more about games like FIFA. So I decided to ask a few participants and spectators what FIFA means to them.
Well, this would be my first time to a competition, so based on the crowd, I guess it attracts a lot of people. So yeah, I guess that it's quite huge. I think everyone likes FIFA over other video games. So.
I play a lot. It's pretty good. I like it because like every year is the EA Sports, the guys that produce it, do a new one. Gets more realistic. It's more enjoyable and competitive as well.
Well, it makes the game more realistic. Every year they make one. So I guess I don't play that often, but yeah, I kind of like it. Which I suck at it, but yeah, I'm just an amateur.
Well, from what I see, it's pretty evident from the last tournament that it's big, a lot of people come, and a lot of people are good, so it shows that a lot of people play soccer. And there's also PNG, a lot of people like to play soccer, so there's no doubt that people would enjoy playing FIFA. Oh yeah, I've been playing since I was 7, FIFA 7 on my PSP back then. And then yeah, I just kept getting every single FIFA each year till FIFA 17. And what I can say about 17 is it's the best one so far, obviously, because it's the latest FIFA right now. But I think some improvements are the input delay and the E8ing when you play online. I mean, there's lots of problems with E8ing, how EA apparently helps weaker team score against stronger team. I don't know, it's an issue, but I haven't really come across that, but I hear a lot of people talking about it. But all in all, I think FIFA 17 is a good game, a lot better than PES for me, because it's just more smoother, and the licensing, how all the clubs are licensed and the leagues, it just makes it more authentic, unlike PES, because PES is all around, it's just not licensed, only for like some clubs and some leagues, so that's why I think FIFA's better.
Hide out, forced away inside, now they want us to surrender, us to surrender. But I could go all night right here between their crossfire, send them off a message, I send a message, say give it up, give it up, we've got no place to go.
As well as what they think about FIFA compared to other competitive video games like Call of Duty or Tekken.
Yeah, I'd say FIFA is pretty the top game because, you know, a lot of people follow soccer as well, so. Plus, FIFA is more complex, like you can play the World Cup, and whereas Call of Duty is more just shooting and killing plus the other games.
I'm not sure because I haven't been to the Tekken or the COD tournament, so that's hard for me to say. But since I've been to all the FIFA, I think I'll rank FIFA as number one and then probably COD and Tekken. So that's just how I see it.
I would, from my opinion, I'd say that it evens out with Call of Duty. A lot of people like first-person shooter games and then some like multiplayer, so I wouldn't say. I kind of like COD better than FIFA because I can play COD better than FIFA, so I'd go with COD.
And whether or not it's difficult for noobs like me to get into FIFA.
No, I don't think so. I mean, as long as you know how to pass to the next player and you know how to score, that's basically what you need to know. It's normal soccer, it's just on Chelsea.
Well, yeah, I guess it's okay for beginners to start a FIFA because, you know, there's lots of mini games and skill games that could help them improve as they continue to play FIFA. There's FIFA Trainer which gives them like step by steps on how to play the game. Yeah.
Yeah, it is. Depends on the level of the people you're playing with. So if the beginners play against themselves, they can build their level. Playing up. Yeah.
So if you ever have a hankering for FIFA, just come on down to Toro Gaming. You'll learn more about the game and you'll even get to try out a couple matches for yourself. Until next time, I'll see you guys later on Tech People.
Thanks, Godreeeman. That was Tech People bringing to you the FIFA Gaming Tournament. And that's all we have for you on this episode. It's been a great pleasure having your company, and I hope you've picked out a thing or two in this week's collection of household tips and stories. Furthermore, do check out our Facebook page for updates and let us know what you think and what you'd like to see more of in the coming episodes. And if you'd like to catch up on the previous editions, please visit MTV online. I'm Theresa Miria. Be sure to join us next week, same time, for more tips and ideas on home and lifestyle improvement. Now, on behalf of the House and Home team, pleasant viewing, take care, and enjoy the rest of the week.
Improving lifestyle. Improving lifestyle. It's all about the betterment for your life. With